Okay, this is example 3. Okay, I can see que a square is 9. Therefore, a is 3. And b square is 1. B is 1. I can see also que the hyperbola have the transversal axis parallel. 2x axis, and the reason is clear, because the positive term is located in the x axis, so it's parallel to the x axis, no? And c square is equal a square root b square. This is 9 plus 1 is 10, therefore c is a square root 10. The square root is approximately 3.16. Okay, now ready, center. Center es lo que es h, coma k. H es 2, k es negative 3. Okay, let me try to do a roughly sketch to understand this. 2, 1, 2. And negative 3, 1, 2, 3. Here is center. But vertex is more complicated. Vertex is located at the distance A, okay, 3, in both directions, left and right. Since left and right, so is you're subtracting 3, so the x component, so 2 minus 3 and negative 1. Negative 1, comma, negative 3, approximately like that. Negative 1, negative 3, here is one vertex. And addition 3, and 2, and 3, F5. The other point is 5, comma, negative 3. Force is similar, but the quantity is no 5, is no 3, sorry, is 3.16, so the answer is very, very similar, negative 1.16, comma negative 3, and 5.16, comma negative 3. Okay, remember this is a very called hyperbola, and the formula to the asymptote is y minus k is equal plus or minus b over a parenthesis x minus h. Now a specific example, y minus k is 3 minus 3, so it's plus 3. Plus or minus b, b is 1, a 3, 1 third parenthesis x minus 2. This is the equation for the asymptote. Now let's see the graph in detail, now in decimals. This is the graph of the example 3. Center, 2, comma, negative 3. Vertex, negative 1, negative 3. Positive 5, negative 3. This is the point of the reference rectangle. Foci, located in negative 1.16, comma, negative 3. And 5.16, comma, negative 3. And this is the asset. Positive slope, negative slope. Okay, example 4, hyperbola, now complete the square. 11 is common factor in the x power. We have x squared minus 6x plus box. Minus 2 is common factor in the y power. Y squared plus 2y. Because you know more plus or minus, plus another box. It's equal in the right hand side, we have minus 75 plus two boxes. The number inside in the first box is 9, because 6 divided by 2 is 3, square is 9. The number inside the second is 1, because 2 divided by 2 is 1, is equal to 1. It's a 9, 11 is 99. And 1 times 2 is minus 2. Okay, good. Now for the research. 11 parentheses x minus 3 squared. But this is minus or plus? Oh, it's minus. X minus. Okay. Minus 2y plus 1 squared equal 75 and 77. 22. This is 22. Divided by 22 now. Entire equation by 22. We have x minus 3 squared divided by 2 minus y plus 1 squared divided by 11 equal. Okay. Identification. Again, this hyperbola, the transverse axis parallel to the x-axis. A squared is 2, then A is radical 2, and radical 2 is approximate 1.41. B squared is 11, B is equal to radical 11, and radical 11 is approximate 3.32. And C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. This is the formula. And the formula is 11 plus 2 is 13. And the square root 13 is approximately 3.6. Okay. The center of this hyperbola is located at the point 3, -1. And the rest we can see in this one, the vertex, the foci, and the asymptote. The equation for the asymptote is y minus k, -1, is equal to plus or minus b, what is b? B is radical 11, divided by radical 2. Parenthesis x minus 3. This is the equation for the asymptote. You can leave it like that. Okay, this is the graph of the outward hyperbola. The center is 3, -1. The vertex is 1.58, -1, and 4.41. Positive off. Okay, and we are doing the foci. The foci is, the distance is 3.6 from this point, 3.6 in the other direction, 6.6, -1, and -0.6, -1. We construct then the reference rectangle. In this case, the asymptote equation. Well, let me see after in the next page.